Hello everyone, and welcome back to our series on the 10 kilowatt AM transmitter installation. In the previous two videos, we made significant progress by successfully installing the transmitter and connecting the copper tube between the antenna and the ATU. We also conducted tests without opening most of the transmitter and without activating the amplifier, and everything went smoothly. In today's video, we'll delve deeper into the functionality of the transmitter. I will provide a brief introduction to the main components and modules of this 10 kilowatt AM transmitter. We explore switches, cooling fans, modulation modules, high voltage and low voltage transformers, low voltage transformer filter components, transmitter amplifier fuses, relays, the built-in ATU module, and the power amplifier module. Make sure to like this video and subscribe to our channel so you won't miss any updates. We appreciate your support. Without further ado, let's dive into the fascinating inner world of 10 kilowatt AM transmitter. Component number one, the power switches. There are generally two switches, a low voltage switch and a high voltage switch. First, let's discuss the high voltage switch. To access it, we go to the back of the transmitter and open the back panel. On the left side, we can see a heavy duty switch designed to handle high currents and high voltage levels, usually several kilowatts, without significant power loss or arcing. Pulling the switch down turns off the high voltage power supply, while lifting it turns it on. Moving on to the low voltage switch, we turn the handle and open the front panel. By pulling the low voltage power switch, we cut off the low voltage power supply to the transmitter. The low voltage switch mainly controls the low voltage circuit and auxiliary components of the transmitter, including control circuits, signal processing units, cooling fans, and various auxiliary components. When the low voltage power supply is turned off, the indicator lights on the front panel buttons will be off. The high voltage switch and low voltage switch plays crucial roles in ensuring safety, facilitating maintenance and service operations, controlling power distribution, improving energy efficiency, and protecting against faults in a 10 kilowatt AM transmitter. Component number two, the cooling fan. The cooling fans in a 10 kilowatt AM transmitter are crucial for dissipating heat, maintaining proper temperature levels, ensuring component reliability, enhancing efficiency, and promoting overall safety and uninterrupted operation. They work in conjunction with the heat sinks or heat dissipating components of the power amplification section and the transmitter as a whole. By dissipating heat generated by the electronic components like power transistors or tubes, as well as the associated power supply components, the cooling fans help maintain optimal temperature levels within the transmitter. This ensures reliable and efficient operation, preventing overheating and potential damage to the components. Component number three, the modulator. The modulator section in the 10 kilowatt AM transmitter combines the audio signal with the carrier frequency to generate the modulated audio signal that carries the audio information. This section takes the processed audio signal, adjusts its amplitude according to the carrier wave, and ensures the linearity and fidelity of the modulation process. By accurately encoding the audio onto the carrier wave, the modulator section plays a crucial role in transmitting high-quality audio over the airwaves. Component number four, the high voltage transformer. The high voltage transformer in a 10 kilowatt AM transmitter steps up the voltage from the power supply to a higher level required by the power amplifier. By utilizing electromagnetic induction, it transfers electrical energy efficiently and allows the transmitter to generate desired RF power output. Without the high voltage transformer, it would be challenging to achieve the necessary high voltage levels needed for efficient RF power generation. Component number five, the low voltage transformer. The low voltage transformer in a 10 kilowatt AM transmitter steps down the voltage from a higher level to a lower level suitable for powering the control circuit, signal processing units, and auxiliary components. By utilizing electromagnetic induction, it facilitates the safe and efficient operation of these circuits by supplying them with the required low voltage. Component number six, filters for low voltage transformer. The black components located next to the low voltage transformer including the second layer, are the filter components associated with the load voltage transformer. The filter components are typically used to minimize electrical noise and interference in the load voltage power supply to ensure a clean and stable power supply for the load voltage circuit. Component number 7, fuse cables for power amplifier. Adjacent to the second layer of black filters component, there is a row of red cables. These red cables serve as fuse cables for the power amplifier section of the transmitter, each with distinct specifications. Fuse cables, also known as fusible links, act as fuses themselves, protecting the amplifier section from excessive current in the 10 kW AM transmitter. When the current exceeds a certain threshold, the fuse cable's conductor melts, breaking the circuit and preventing damage to the amplifier component. Proper replacement and maintenance of fuse cables are important to ensure continued protection and safe operation of the transmitter. Component number 8, the relay section. The relay section is installed on the third floor. The relay section in a 10 kW AM transmitter consists of electromagnetic relays that controls different functions and circuits within the transmitter. They serve as switches, allowing or interrupting the flow of electrical current. The relays are controlled by control circuits to enable specific actions, functions, or routing within the transmitter, ensuring proper operation and protection. Component number 9, the built-in ATU. The 9th component is the built-in antenna tuning unit, also known as ATU or antenna tuner of the AM transmitter. Built-in ATU section in the 10 kW AM transmitter is responsible for matching the impedance of the transmitter to that of the antenna system. By adjusting the inductors, capacitors, and matching network, it ensures efficient power transfer and minimizes power reflections, optimizing the performance of the AM transmission. Component number 10, the power amplifier. The final component will be the transmitter power amplifier module. The amplifier module amplifies the low power audio signals from the modulator to a high power RF signal for transmission. It consists of driver stages, power amplifier stages, and output battery networks working together to boost the signal's power while maintaining signal fidelity. The amplifier module is crucial for achieving the desired coverage and signal strength in the AM transmission. The power of the transmitter is the combined output of the power of multiple power amplifiers, which is why so many power amplifiers are needed. The total number of power amplifiers in the transmitter is 48 pieces. In this video, I present an overview of the 10 main components of the 10 kW AM transmitter, including switches, cooling fans, modulator, high and low voltage transformer, low voltage transformer filter components, transmitter amplifier fuses, relays, built-in ATU, and power amplifier modules. In the next video, I will demonstrate the correct operation of a 10 kW AM transmitter and summarize the AM broadcast project in Kapanaduan, Philippines. Feel free to comment on this video and explore the additional project details in the video description for a comprehensive understanding. Stay tuned and learn about operational aspects and get an overview of the entire project. See you in the next video.